So epigenetics is a term that people are hearing about more and more, and it turns out epigenetics is kind of the explanation for why this time of conception is so important. So the genes we get from our mum and our dad that come through the sperm and the eggs into the embryo, well, they can't really be altered. You know, they're kind of the pattern of the DNA, which is set in stone, and that's the genetic code. But there's an extra layer of information that comes with the DNA structure, and it's a small change in the physical structure of the DNA that's caused by this epigenetics that can modify the way the genes can be turned on and off in the embryo and then the baby. So the structure of the DNA, this epigenetics that we're talking about, it can be responsive to things in the environment in such a way as to have an impact on the health of the baby. And there are several things in the environment that can change epigenetics. One of the main ones is whether or not you've got enough folic acid in your diet. So lots of these, fruit and vegetables to make sure you've got good vitamin and mineral exposure, and especially the folic acid is really critical for getting the right epigenetics in the embryo. But then there can be some exposures that aren't so good for epigenetics, and that's where these chemicals and especially the endocrine disrupting chemicals come into it. So if people want to find out more about how to prepare for healthy pregnancy and plan for a healthy baby, they should take a look at the website. The Your Fertility website has a lot of really wonderful information on it.